All right, today I want to talk about speech synthesis. So this is how to turn text into speech within the browser. So this is a web API built into all of the browsers. We've got support across all the major browsers. Each one of the browsers comes with the same list of, currently it's 162 different voices. Now a voice is something that sounds more masculine, more feminine. It's got an accent for a specific language. So there's a whole bunch of these, like I said, 162 across a bunch of different languages that we can use. So in my example, what I'm going to do is I'm going to build this page. We're going to add the functionality to it so that when we click the read button, it's going to read the text that's inside both of these inputs. And it'll do it using one of the voices that we're going to load into this list. Then we can adjust the pitch, the rate, the volume for that when we play it back. And we also have the ability to pause and resume the playback. So this is what we're building. Now I've already gone ahead and I've added a little bit of CSS. I've added the starter HTML and I've added click listeners to these things. I've added the input listener for the dropdown list, but none of the code having to do with speech synthesis is in there. So we have two main objects. There is the speech synthesis object and the speech synthesis utterance. Now, there are other objects, but these are the two that we need to be able to achieve what it is that we're looking to do. Speech synthesis, that's the main object that controls the API. So this is the thing that you play and pause and resume. Speech synthesis utterance is, here's the combination of a particular voice with a particular set of text. And you can add a queue of these things. So we can add a whole list of things to read, and it will just read them one at a time. It'll go through. It won't try to talk over itself. It will maintain the queue and read them in order. So those are the two objects we need. So let's dive into the code here. Here we have the basic page. Like I said, we've got the two inputs. Type equals text. So there is the value that we want to read out. You can edit this, change it in the browser and have it read different things. Here's our buttons with the IDs. We've already got click listeners in our script. I'll show you those in a second. We have a drop-down list, a select element, where we're going to load all the browsers that are available in the browser. I'm going to filter the list so it's just the English ones that I get. You can do whatever you like with that list. And then my three range sliders, one for pitch, one for rate, and one for volume. And I've already got the listeners on those, so it will update the value that's written right here inside this span as you adjust it. All right. So our script, I've got an immediately invoked function expression. So this function is going to run when the page loads. I'm using up here in my script tag, I've got type set to module, so it will delay it. It's not going to run this script until after the page is finished loading and this module has completely been read. But when that happens, this function is going to run. And here we have our change event for the drop-down list, the click event for the read button, the click event for the pause, click event for the resume. We'll come back and talk about these in a little bit. And the input events for those three sliders. So that's what we have. Now I have a global variable here called voice. This is going to be my selection from the dropdown list. I'm going to save it here. This will be a voice object that we're saving. Speech synthesis. So this is window.speech synthesis. You can write it as window.speech synthesis or just speech synthesis. Same thing, pointing to the same object. This is going to be what we call when we want to pause, resume, and speak. So to have it read some text. We're also going to need to have a variable called voices. We don't have to call it voices, but I'm going to call it voices. This is going to be the array of voice objects. Now, we can here say that we're going to call speech synthesis or synth, that's our object, get voices. So this is going to try and retrieve the whole list of all the available voices. Now, in my testing, what I found is sometimes this works great, no problem, right out of the box. Other times, you need a little bit of a delay. For some reason, the list comes back as an empty array when the page first loads. So what I'm going to do is inside my addListeners function that runs at the very start, I'm going to set a little tiny delay, and I'm going to do it so it's happening 100 milliseconds after the page finishes loading, or after this script has loaded. So we'll say set timeout, and inside of here in my function, that's going to run after 100 milliseconds, so a tenth of a second. I'm going to do the same thing right here. I'm going to call voices, and there it is. So I'm going to set the value. I'm going to attempt to set the value again. Now, you could put an if statement around here to say that if the length of voices is zero, then we're going to run this. So we're not calling it twice if we don't need to. And then load voices is going to be my function where I want to build the select list. So I'm going to take this array called voices, and I want to populate. So in here, I want to fill this drop-down list with all the available ones. And as I said before, I'm just going to take the English ones from this list. So every voice that we get, so we're going to loop through this array called voices. We're going to get a voice object. Each one of the values in that array is a voice object. They each will have a lang property, which will be equal to something like en-us, en-ca, something like that. There will also be a name where you get the name of the voice. You know, it could be something like Karen or Phil or George, Gerard. There is a long list, like I said, 162 of these voices. So there's going to be a name. And there's also a default, which is going to be a Boolean set to true or false. And this will be true for one of the voices in that list. So we can get the default one. We know which one is currently selected if you loop through this array of voices. So we are going to loop through that to build our drop-down list. So let's create a for loop. We'll say let I equals 0 as long as I is less than voices.length. There we go. And inside of here, I'm going to check to see if the language that we're saying right here, if it doesn't include or doesn't start with, is even better. So starts with en dash. So if it's not that, it means it's not one of the English ones. I will continue, which means it will jump back up to the next iteration in the for loop. So this will automatically trigger the incrementing of the loop and continue to the next one. So this way, I'm not doing anything if the voice language doesn't start with en. All right, if it does, then we're going to say, let's create an option. And the text content inside of there, we can write this out however we want, but the name and then the language going to be inside of there. And we'll see that there's en, US, en, CA, en, GB, AU for Australia. So lots of different English variants on there, and this will give us different accents. Now, if it is the default one, then what I'm going to do here is I'm going to add a CSS class name to it that we can refer back to later. And if you want to do any different styling, then you can do that. So in the CSS, I've got a class called Picked. I'm just changing the alignment of the text from left to right. But you can do whatever you like in terms of the styling to highlight which one is shown. Then we can set this voice up here at the top. This was the selected voice. So when the page first loads, when we're building this drop-down list, we want to save. All right, if whatever one is marked as default, wherever default is set to true, that is the voice that we want to save. So I'm going to save that so I can use it without having to pick something from the drop-down list. Just automatically, that will be available for me. Now I'm going to save the name and the lang attributes inside of each of the options. So if I want to use it later, I can. So I'll say set attribute, data lang, and data name. There we go. We take those two things, we save them, and then we append. So voice select, this is my drop-down list in the page, and I'm going to append the option. All right, so let's check that out. And there we are. So aligned to the right, there is the currently selected one. This is the default voice that you get when the page first loads. but we have this long list. So you can see there's Irish, US English, Australian, Great Britain, Indian. So we have all kinds of different accents, and we're going to have to set this up. Right now, the read doesn't do anything, but we're able to select and change this. So we have an event listener for picking one of the items in the list, but we're not doing anything with that right now. So let's set that up next. We'll do the change voice. This is the one that's going to pick a different value from the list and set it as voice, that global variable that we had. All right, so again, we'll going to deal with the voices array to loop through it and find the matching one. So our voices array that we have, this one that it's that Copilot is showing me, voices is the array of the ones that I've picked. So it's just the English ones. So I'm going to loop through that, and I need to get the value of the selected index from inside of that drop-down list. So as the user picks something here, I need to get this value. And there's going to be the data name attribute, the data lang attribute. So if I get the name, I should be able to match that against the current voice. So let's get the select first of all. So say const select. That's going to be ev.target. And the index, so the selected index, is going to be select.selectedIndex. So the name, we're going to go to the select, and we can say children, we can say options, whichever one of those you want to use. So index, that's going to give me the actual option tag that is currently selected. I'm going to get the name. So once we have that name, now I'm going to loop through voices and find the matching one and set that, just like we did here. Voice is going to be equal to that. So we will loop through voices. If voice's name is equal to our name variable that we created right here, then we're setting voice equal to the one from that array. Now we should also deal with the class. I was setting a class on the selected one right here, like this, picked. Since I'm doing that, I should remove the class when I'm changing the value here. So we can do that. We can say that if select.querySelector dot picked. We can remove the attribute class. That's one way of stripping it out. So if this exists, we're going to remove this class attribute right here. And then inside of here, when we do find the match, now what I need to do is the select.options subindex. That's the one that we've picked. Or I can use I, which is the loop variable. It's the same either way, but we're going to add this picked class on there. All right, so back refreshed. Samantha's the default. When I pick a new one, there you go. Now Daniel is the selected one, and we should have voice being selected as that. So let's console log voice and see what we're getting here when we change the value. So when I pick something like Daniel, there we go. Here is the speech synthesis voice object. So this is a voice object that we have in our array of voices. We've picked one of them. So the language, English, Great Britain. There's the name and default, false. That was not the default one, but we've now marked it as the voice that we want to use. I want to use this when I read these things out. When I click this, I'm going to have to call the speak method on this to get it to read the text. But just doing that alone is not going to make it use the voice that I want. What I have to do is I have to create one of these. I have to create a speech synthesis utterance. And with that, then I can load in and I'll have the ability to change these values as well. I can load in the voice. And then with that set, I can use speech synthesis to say speak. All right, so this is into our final one, the read paragraphs. So when you click the read button, our read paras function that I have right here, this is where we're going to handle it. So I'm going to create a new speech utterance. Now let's just do it for the first input. Instead of looping through first, I'll just create one so we see how that works. So we'll say const inputs. And just to be clear about which ones I'm talking about, it's going to be the ones inside the sentences section. So if I look in the HTML, it's these two right here that I'm going to get. Now there are also inputs down here. I don't want those. What I want is just these two inside of this div. So this is going to give me the array. It should have two, and I will create one text. We'll say const txt is going to be equal to inputs number 0 dot value. There we have, that's the first one. So I'm going to do that just for this first one, and then we'll turn this into a loop and have it read all the text. So let's create my speech synthesis utterance. Now this one we do have to declare new on, and we're passing in the text. So that creates the base object. It puts the text inside of here. Now we have the chance to change the voice, the rate, the pitch, the volume. All those properties can be changed on this object. So we can say utter.voice equals voice, our global variable. This is the one that we want to use. So with that set, I can now call the speech method on the synth object. And I just pass in this utterance object that we created right here. So synth.speak, and we pass in our utterance. So now I can pick this. That is now selected as our voice, and read.
So I asked my girlfriend Matilda if she wanted to waltz.
And that's it. That's all there is to it. So let's do both of those things just to show how to build up a queue. So instead of targeting this, what I'm going to do is I'm going to wrap this in a loop. We'll say inputs.forEach. So in my array, I will look at each input, and this is going to be my function. Now inside of here, I'm going to paste these items. So instead of input 0, this is now going to be the inputs 0. It'll be input.value. So this will be the first, then the second one. For both of them, we're going to create an utterance. We're going to set the voice. Now, if we want, we can change the rate, pitch, and volume, which we'll come back and do after we test this one out. And at the end, we call it. After we've done this loop and we've created all of these new things, then I want to, oh, sorry. Yes, we will do this inside the loop. I'm going to call speech inside the loop. So I'm going to be calling speech twice. There's two things. I'm calling speak twice. And this is the important part. It will build a queue of the things to read. So here we have the two things. I'll just do the default voice.
So I asked my girlfriend Matilda if she wanted to waltz. Pineapple, apple, pen.
And there we have it. The two things being read. Now we can change the pitch on this default voice. So the higher this number, it's a value between 0 and 2, the higher the number, the higher the pitch.
So, I asked my girlfriend Matilda if she wanted to waltz. Pineapple, apple, pen.
So, pause and resume are working right now. I can do those.
I asked my girl.
And it's just calling the pause and resume methods on the synth object that we called speech on. My pitch didn't change anything because we didn't actually add the code to accept the change in value here. So let's go back and do that right now. So right down in here, we're going to set the rate, we're going to set the pitch, we're going to set the volume, those three things. So we're getting from our input range selectors, inside of those, we're getting the values, and we're setting them as the values here. That's all it takes. And then we're just changing whatever that default voice is. We're adding additional information. We're updating what the default is set within that voice for those values. Come back in here. We can do the default.
So I asked my girlfriend Matilda if she wanted to waltz. Pineapple, apple, pen.
There we go. It's red. Now, if I take the pitch and I jack it way up to 2.
So I asked my girlfriend Matilda if she wanted to waltz. Pineapple, apple, pen.
Or we take the pitch and we bring it way down.
So, I ask my girlfriend Matilda if she wanted to waltz. Pineapple apple pen.
And then you can pick another voice. Go down here, let's take Rishi. And we'll leave this at the default. So these values, 1, 1, those are the default for all the voices. And it's sort of, that's the starting point for that voice, and then you can modify it from there.
So, I asked my girlfriend Matilda if she wanted to waltz. Pineapple apple pen.
And adjusting this volume while I'm doing the playback changes nothing, because I've set it within the utterance and the voice what that value is going to be. So it's after I've done this. Now, when I click read,
I asked my girlfriend,
and I click pause, it's read to about here. It's read about this much of that first one. If I click read again, nothing is happening because we have paused the playback. So it's just adding. Every time I click read, it's adding to that cue. So right now there's the other half of this, and then the new one that was added, which was this and this, and then this and this again. So when I resume...
And Matilda, if she wanted to waltz. Pineapple apple pen. So, I asked my girlfriend Matilda if she wanted to waltz. Pineapple apple pen.
So there we have it. It got added to the cue each time I clicked read, even if it's paused. So we have to resume to get through the rest of it. And that's it. That is all that it takes. Now, you don't have to have all these controls. It's really just building these objects. You need to call speech synthesis, create one of these objects so that you can call the speak method. You need to get the list of voices so you can pick one from the list, and you can just pick it yourself, hard code it to be one of the voices from that list. And then you will call new speech synthesis utterance, pass it the text that you want to be read, and then the object that is created with that, that's where you set the voice, and then you pass that to the speak method. And there you go. Now you can have your web pages reading back content to people. All right, so I hope that helps you out. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments. I answer as many as I have time for. If you're looking for a copy of the code, if you look down in the description, you'll find a link to the code gist. And as always, thanks for watching.